If you have ever found yourself procrastinating, start here. My action plan for procrastination, or MAPP, is your personalized action plan. MAPP uses evidence-based science, proven pro tips, and brain boosters for overcoming procrastination. MAPP will help you get started, stay focused, and keep learning. This video presents MAPP 3, Keep Learning. Remembering is central to learning, but the working memory can only retain so much at once. Feeling overloaded can naturally lead to difficulty remembering, a lack of follow-through, and procrastination. MAPP 3 helps you overcome this type of procrastination with a memory technique known as chunking. Chunking lightens the load on the working memory by breaking information into small groups so the brain runs more efficiently, you don't get overloaded, and you can keep learning. Chunking is based on the science that tells us the working memory is quick but has limited capacity to hold information. In fact, research shows that working memory can hold only 4 pieces of new information at once. When trying to memorize 9 digits, 1 digit at a time, for instance, the working memory will quickly reach capacity and forget the first numbers in order to hold more. Chunking the numbers creates fewer numbers for the working memory to process. The brain more easily integrates chunked information with the long-term memory. You can use chunking to learn any subject, be it a new language, a musical instrument, a sport, or academic concept. To use MAPP 3, start here. Use chunking during focused study time. When reading a difficult text, divide it into parts. You can divide it by section, by key points, or by features such as the elements of an argument. Chunking involves breaking down and grouping any information into useful or meaningful units. You can also use chunking to group small pieces together, like grouping important terms, related examples, or details that fit a pattern. You can also connect related chunks together, combining chunks with similar uses and synthesizing chunks with similar meanings. This is how you keep learning. Here's a tip. Pause to reflect and recap information between chunks. When you chunk, you are creating a space between units, so it helps to also visualize this space. Visualizing is, in fact, another technique for memorizing information, so using graphic organizers increases the effectiveness of chunking. Depending on what you are reading and why, you may have different categories, but the general idea behind using a graphic organizer is to organize information by criteria or category so you can analyze it and remember it. One column could be for key points. Here, you would reduce long passages into short summary statements or paraphrase important sentences. Another column could be for reflecting on how this information is being used or what it means. Another column could be for why this information is important. You can also use graphic organizers to record new vocabulary or unfamiliar terms, chunking new words in a list and defining them and noting the context in which they were used. Here's a tip. Include a column for notes. Here you can note the source information or note the information's relevance to your project or imagine other uses for it. After chunking, take a break. Breaks are brain boosters that are essential to the learning process, creating connections between chunks and overcoming procrastination. And here's a final brain booster for you. Give yourself a good night's sleep every night. Evidence-based science on how the brain learns shows that during sleep, what you learned during the day deepens and even consolidates into chunks, which improves your memory, your problem-solving skills, and the learning process. Sleep helps you keep learning.